And if we wanted to explore really quickly, we could ditch the forager and just send the flying units. Yes, I remember that. We get Caris, and he's meant to be used as a governor. But I want someone to lead my armies, and I've already invested our first hero with 3 points in food creation, so he's not going to be the best unit to be leading an army here. Weatherman, do my heroes suffer from, if I get like a Valtar hero or a Broken Lords hero, will they suffer from disease from my units here? Alright, so we have a new empire plan we can take. These things have already been pacified down. That is two orc villages. If we can kill the Broken Lords, grabbing two orc villages for ourselves would be really nice. Alright. The longer we wait, the further behind we'll fall. So, perhaps we should take the military production bonus and the science bonus. How's our dust doing? Our dust, we have decent dust. If we push in all directions, we might not have enough to declare war, but we should accumulate enough. No, let's not worry about the dust. No, we'll use that now, and I will assign someone to dust since retrofitting could be really useful for us here. And we have a huge food bonus if I want someone working food. Okay, that's fine. Burrow streets into Necrodrone Forager. We'll pump units like crazy and then try to overwhelm the Broken Lords before it's too late. Let's see, military wise, they have an extremely strong military. Well, this is going to be interesting. And by interesting, I mean, I worry that this is not going to work at all. All right, let's visit these ruins and also try to find out where the Broken Lord City is within this province. Burrow Streets, Necrodrone in front of the Forager, and Forager in front of the Necrodrone. Okay, so we'll search these ruins. Another bit of dust. Search these ruins. Okay, so this city, there is a Broken Lord army nearby. They don't have ranged units either. All stalwarts. That means perhaps we can make these guys cheaper by getting rid of the Sharp Senses granting ring. Let's see, how long is it going to take us to get over to Alchemical Alloys? That'll be the next tech we research. We have a decent amount of titanium here, enough to pump out a couple units. And by a couple, I mean, say, six might be okay. If they're only using three titanium, so probably only five. All right, well, while we're here, let's do some more rune searching. Nothing at that location. Right, so we're under attack here. That's not in our favor. Now we could flee, split the forager off, and then just escape with the Necrodrones. All right, so we'll retreat there. All right, so if I split off the forager, that leaves the Necrodrones free to run away. Until we return with a stronger army. And the forager. Yeah, let's just run over here and get a little more vision on this area. Alright, back into our own territory then, and I'll keep on exploring with this forager on the location of the second Broken Lord city if possible. Burrow streets, and then a whole bunch of units. Yes, the forager does live. Alright, so it looks like he's got the Broken Lord hero. Broken Lord faction player has another city right here. I do see some the marks of an exploit. Yep. I'll just go back to the city to heal up. And wow, the necrophagy bonus healing is pretty significant. We're already almost fully healed. Alright, let's get a good look at this city. He's got 4 units in the garrison, 1 burrow out. It's a nice looking burrow too, with a fountain in the center. Next, Tech Era. Let's go unlock the improved weapons there. Cannon fodder. Cool. Is that a tech we already have, or do we need to research that? All right, that would save us a lot of dust per turn. And we also want the proliferator. Okay, Necrodrones, stay home and heal, please. Alchemical alloys in 9. Let's shift people over to science. Alchemical alloys in 5 now. Yeah, that should do. That should do nicely. All right, I'm surprised the forager hasn't been attacked yet. The Necrodrones around there. Well, we can do another quick bit of scouting. So these guys are now fully healed. Let's see if we can search that before we get attacked. No. All right, well, we can certainly retreat. Fifty dust, and yeah, I keep on running there, little forager. Ooh, what's this? Meteor fields. Just a boost to science and production. Right, so is this all Broken Lord territory now? Well, there is one unclaimed region here. And we'll have alchemical alloys soon. Pump up those units and then retrofit them. I'm actually impressed at how much scouting this lone forager has managed to do. All right, our army's coming along soon. We don't want these guys to be intercepted, but we do move very quickly, and we're flying so we can move over impassable terrain. Let's see, over this way. Inspect some more of the surrounding territory. We'll grab those runes and then head home. Okay, so our first target is going to be this city right here. I don't know if our meager army is going to do anything about that, but we will. We do have the gold, we do have the titanium to do a whole bunch of retrofits so we can make our guys as strong as possible. We'll even attach the hero, although that does mean slowing our growth in this city. Alright, so we're going to go and retreat here. The next time we get attacked, though, will be the last time. Okay, we could hide all the way down here. Maybe they won't find us. Ten titanium. Alright, so we're going to go full titanium then. We don't have any glass steel. Chemical alloys next turn. We'll also have the proliferator up. Or in 6 turns, rather. Alright, so let's upgrade these unit profiles. Titanium Claws gives us level 3 sweep strike back and much better stats than the non-titanium claws. Alright, now if we get him up to level 2 gear and improved movement. No, I think 6 movement is enough. We'll apply that. Now the foragers. Sweep strike back or range layer block. We'll go with the claws then. I don't see any ranged units wandering around with the Broken Lord in the Broken Lord territory yet. So we'll apply that. Now let's see. These guys will pop all of them out. Pop out a forager. Oh, we do need a sewer system. And we do want to be happy again, so we'll take some time off of that. Finish off the sewer system and then switch back to science. Alright, and unfortunately, our forager finally met his demise. But what do we want to do with these necro drones? We won't be able to sneak by here. I don't really want to have to take retreat damage. Alright, what are these guys saying? Declaration of war. Great. Alright, so we'll have to bring these necro drones back then. And start pumping out these units. Yes, they'll arrive soon. Alright, is this army gonna move off? Does appear to have. Yep, they're entering our territory here. 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll just wait back here for now. The Necro Drones and Forges are coming out. We'll pay to retrofit them. And now that we're content again, we'll switch on over to science production. But not so much that I can't pump these out at a good speed. I would like the proliferator. Alright, we've gained a level. Do we want to continue Unit cost reduction. Okay, let's do that. We'll keep this guy as a dedicated governor. But in the mercenary market, strikes from afar. Does this guy have the same abilities? And is there a way I can check? Well, getting a ranged hero wouldn't help me. Yeah, I don't know. Well, we do want to save our dust for retrofits, so we won't jump on that. But I am still worried that perhaps the poison ability will affect our non-necrophage heroes. The proliferator can plant parasites, and if the unit that's been parasitized dies, we get a free forager unit. So this is a good way to rapidly grow our army. Magnifying glass on the mercenary screen. All right, let's see. I'm interested in the details of this hero. There apparently is a magnifying glass that Echelon team wants me to look at. Mercenary screen, magnifying. Ah, right here. Ha. Yeah, that's exactly what we wanted. Okay, so this guy already has a point in Strength of the Wind. He could also go down these paths. Well, let's see. We've got a few guys popped out here. We can't retrofit because we're under siege. Well, that's a bit of a pain. Alright, let's bring these guys in over here. And then once we pop this forager out, we'll have to break the siege. These guys are level 3 and level 2 stalwarts. Alright, let's see how this battle goes. Our people here are not very advanced. We could retrofit these guys, and we will. And then go and attack. We'll have some guys from the garrison, including our hero. Fine, let's do it. It's an even fight. We do act first, but I don't want to get surrounded here. We could just hide in the corner. Yeah, that seems like a good plan. Let's go as far forward as possible. And this guy over here. And attack. Well, out here, attack. Here, attack. Then the rest of the guys will rush forward. Critical failure. Right, well, let's try to get poison on as many units as possible. Or I guess it's disease, not poison. Right, so we actually, well, I don't want to speak too soon, but we're doing okay here. Maybe this Necrodrone wants to fly away to safety somewhere, say over here. But apart from that, I think we're just fine here. So we'll retrofit all the units that are popping out right now, maybe wait for Proliferator and then move on the Broken Lords. Well, this army is very small compared to what they probably what the rest of their units have tucked away in their main territory. This guy will run away over here. Likewise with this unit. Alright, so we will hang back to heal up. And is there any space in the garrison? There is not. Alright, so we've got the proliferator in 3. And a whole bunch of units that we can go and retrofit. Victory! That's right, Shadowclaw, 9,000. Alright, we're gonna keep things as they are. We still have enough influence to do that. And we can take things off of that and go full production. A proliferator next. Maybe we can squeeze in another burrow that'll keep the influence high. And let us do all those nice empire plans. Let's see, is there a good bit of tile that I want to expand to? Not really, I mean, the forests do give us a little more production. Alright, let's try to level up our main city here then. No, forget about that. We'll push full military and try to absorb the Broken Lords. See you later, Weatherman. Yes, that's right, and we did complete another third of our quest, or step one of our main faction quest. Whoa, someone died already? The dragon died first in both of our playthroughs here. Okay, so it's winter, and we need to push these guys into a new army since we need space for these new units, including the Proliferator, who I will go and deck out with some better stuff. Actually, the Proliferator doesn't need this, it doesn't need titanium. But improved movement might be good. Yeah, since she only has a speed of 2. Unsteady, what does that do? Ah, yes, that'll definitely be useful. Unsteady 2, but with increased initiative. 15, 15, it's the same. This just increases our attack a little more. Alright, fine. We'll give her the titanium weapon here then. Mage Wand, apply, and queuing up a proliferator. Yes, and the Broken Lords are back with some more units. Right, so time to break this siege. Unfortunately, our proliferator didn't get over here in time to do that, or to participate in this battle. Right, ready, fight. All our people had time to heal up. This time, the Broken Lord's heroes are back with a little more life and higher initiative. So since these guys fly, we can no problem with starting them way back here. They can fly in as needed. And our forager. We don't want to be hit first. These guys move 3, 1, 2, 3. Let's just drop. 1, 2, 3. Over here is probably fine. Or way back in the corner. No, this looks good. And we'll have all of our damage spread out to get maximum poisoning. And where are these stalwarts headed off to? Oh yes, I forgot that we don't go first, so telling the Necro Drones to go over here isn't going to be too helpful.